Good evening. Melbourne's worst fears have been realised. COVID is back in aged care, with a positive resident already in hospital and facilities on edge. The acting premier is refusing to rule out extending lockdown, issuing an ominous warning. Dougal Beattie leads tonight's coverage.
A year on from Victoria's deadly second wave, and confirmation today, COVID has once again infected our most vulnerable.
The next few days are going to be so critically important, and that includes the possibility that this outbreak will get worse before it gets better.
Five new cases were recorded before midnight, a further six detected this morning, taking the total cluster to 60. Two were linked to the Whittlesea cluster, three are connected to private aged care. A strong indication the seven-day lockdown is likely to be extended.
We're neck and neck with this virus, and it's an absolute beast.
One new case is the son of the aged care worker from R-Care Maidstone. The second infection is a 99-year-old R-Care resident who is asymptomatic and has been transferred to hospital. Also positive is an unvaccinated R-Care staff member who also worked at Blue Cross Western Gardens in Sunshine from May 26 to 28.
There is no doubt that this situation is incredibly serious.
It's very, very rapidly evolving, and the numbers are huge, and it just speaks to how infectious this virus is.
R-Care Maidstone has gone into lockdown with residents confined to their rooms. So too is Blue Cross in Sunshine. Up until Thursday, staff in the federally regulated aged care sector were still being allowed to work across facilities.
It is massively risky to move across different settings.
The state government maintaining its hands are tied to prevent movement between private aged care sites.
Public aged care is a responsibility of the state government. Private aged care is a responsibility of the federal government.
All remaining R-Care residents and staff were today offered the Pfizer vaccine after it was revealed the second worker missed receiving her COVID jab 3 weeks ago because she was on leave.
If it's a matter of tossing up whether or not the vaccine provides protection for you and by virtue of that to those you care for, please come forward to get vaccinated now.
There are now 279 exposure sites across the city. Among the Tier 1 locations, JMD Grocers in Epping, Healthy India in Reservoir, Inde Filipino at Footscray Market and the Thai High Butcher also at Footscray Market. There are also multiple trips on bus routes 408 and 412 in the western suburbs and Wilmot Park Primary School in Craigieburn, Mercy College in Coburg and MLC in Kew have been closed. Deep cleaning is underway at MLC's senior campus after a staff member tested positive but wasn't infectious while at the school.
Out of an abundance of caution, if those cases are confirmed to be positive, if the preemptive contact tracing work is already underway.
The turnout was again strong at Victoria's mass vaccination hubs today.
We thought we'd come down this morning even though it's 3 degrees.
The testing boss assuring the public long delays are being worked through.
Please check the queues during the course of the afternoon and they are significantly shorter.
And we're live to Dougal now. Dougal, are we any closer to finding the missing link?
Yeah, contact tracers now believe three people might have crossed paths with the man from South Australia. They are now investigating the movements of these three individuals to see if they perhaps are the missing link. Now, the worry is that there might be more undetected cases in the community. And if there is, that means a longer lockdown does loom for Victoria. Now, genomic sequencing is also underway for that first aged care worker to try and find out how she contracted COVID-19. And in some good news tonight, the two aged care centres from the Royal Freemasons are now no longer in lockdown. Pete?
Well, that's at least good news. Thank you, Dougal. Many elderly aged care residents and their staff who care for them are still waiting to be fully vaccinated. Mimi Becker's in Maidstone. Mimi, it's a nervous time.
It really is, Pete, and that's for staff, residents and their families. This aged care facility is in lockdown for the foreseeable future, and given just how quickly COVID spreads, especially in an aged care setting, nobody wants to take any chances. Away from a window and an uncertain smile, these are some of the 75 vulnerable residents holed up inside R-Care aged care.
We're all worried. We just don't know. You don't know what the future holds. It starts with one, then it just multiplies.
Husband and wife, 90-year-old Florence and 91-year-old Graham Hansen, are locked down, their family feeling helpless.
We just have to sit and wait. There's not a lot else we can do at the moment.
While extra PPE was delivered to Maidstone, in Sunshine, residents at Blue Cross Western Gardens were also forced to quarantine. At the height of the pandemic, 655 aged care residents died in Victoria. One of those was 81-year-old Maria Vasilakis from St Basil's in Faulkner.
What we are seeing now today is that their lives, they died in vain.
Families fear history could once again repeat itself.
Actually astounded that 12 months down the track, no lessons have been learnt.
The federal government being blamed for the slow vaccine rollout in aged care. One of the COVID-positive R-Care workers hadn't received a single dose.
The simple answer is 100% of facilities in Victoria have been vaccinated.
The workforce who got vaccinated 3 weeks ago only got vaccinated because there were some extra vaccines available after the residents had received their first dose.
As a result of the outbreak, vaccines were rushed here to R-Care today. Residents and staff given either their first or second dose.
They should have been prioritised, it's as simple as that, but hopefully it's not too late.
But for this woman, an aged care worker, the damage has already been done after she breathed on people at an anti-lockdown protest.
That's pretty disgusting.
That's pretty disgusting.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
Babbitt Care acknowledged she's an employee, but would only say it acknowledges staff are a potential source of introduction of COVID into facilities. Mimi Becker, Nine News.
Hope of a revived JobKeeper hasn't been ruled out if Victoria's lockdown is extended. Mark Santomartino's in Fitzroy North. Mark, till then, businesses are helping workers who've lost their jobs.
Staff here at Horn Please have been cooking up plenty of takeaway orders, Pete, but they're brewing many more for those who are doing it tough. From 5 o'clock every evening during lockdown, they're giving away free curry and rice to those who have lost their jobs, and businesses across the city are doing similar things. Yes, it is a small contribution, but without any JobKeeper and knowing many of their own staff will go without a paycheck this week, these owners know that many will struggle to pay for their rent, let alone their groceries.
Jagdev Singh is used to boxing up and shipping out wine, not food.
With no JobKeeper, the demand has been massive, but we shouldn't have to do it.
Hundreds of care packages for those with nothing, paid forward at the local drop, using fresh fruit and vegetables once destined for restaurants like Jesse Singh's.
There is no income and all the staff has been stood down. We all in the same limbo.
Chef Singh dodged lockdown in Byron Bay, where he's moving one of his Melbourne restaurants.
Trying to get out of Melbourne, it's impossible. I never thought that I have to do that. But this is the only way to survive.
His staff have been giving out free meals since Saturday, knowing how hard lockdown can hit. Applications open on Wednesday for the state's $250 million support package, but that's only for businesses, with the Commonwealth quiet on the chance of JobKeeper returning if the lockdown is extended.
Key word to your question then was if. So, again, it's a hypothetical.
Certainty only the acting Premier could, but wouldn't provide for anyone planning to work, hold a funeral or get married this weekend.
It's just too early for me to provide advice. I think that would be completely unfair on anyone planning something special.
What we need from the government is just to be upfront with us. How long do they think it is going to last and where is the plan to get Victorians out of lockdown?
Plan or not, any more than 7 days is going to hurt.
There's a lot of jobs online, my own jobs online, my own livelihood online. So just got to do what need to survive.
Mark Santomartino, Nine News.
The government has defended allowing film crews to continue shooting an American TV show during the 7 day lockdown. Filming for NBC series La Brea went ahead in Port Melbourne today. The state government says it's a permitted industry with a COVID-safe plan, and the show was already in production before lockdown. Chief Health Officer Brett Sutton says a return to the Ring of Steel around Melbourne is not out of the question. The idea is welcomed by some regional communities locked down hundreds of kilometres from the outbreak's epicentre. Andrew Lund reports from Mildura.
On the banks of the Murray River, Mildura's famous paddle steamers sit tied up, going nowhere. While the wharf is in Victoria, Their base is across the water in New South Wales, so the family business doesn't qualify for any government help.
We're not recognised as being shut down, and we're not being recognised as a Victorian business.
In the quiet centre of town, the statewide lockdown is wearing thin.
Terrible. Hate it. Yeah, 600 kilometres from Melbourne. Why are we locked down? If we had two cases up here, would they lock down Melbourne?
It's been a heartbreaking blow for the travelling Sesame Street Circus, forced to cancel its opening shows, but locals have pitched in to help with offers of coffee and food.
It's a rough time for everyone, not just us, and to see people still giving and still trying to be kind in hard times is, yeah, it's very heartwarming.
And with no active cases in regional Victoria, Mildura's mayor says a ring of steel around Melbourne could help life return to normal.
That's what's been suggested from this end of the state for a very long time.
It's all to be determined as we go through a review of the situation day by day, but it is not out of the question. It is not locked in.
While Mildura's isolation has helped keep COVID out, it's now also hampering residents' ability to get vaccinated.
We don't have a state vaccination centre here, so that means that it's not possible for people aged 40 to 49 to get the COVID jab.
The government says teams from Bendigo are providing weekly visits, with plans to open a vaccination centre in town now underway. In Mildura, Andrew Lund, Nine News.